Today, I am changing things up here to review something very different from here on out. During my intermission after the last review of the BMW M4, I made a decision and created a list of reviewing fun sports cars that are incredibly affordable and cheap, because I know something like this unusual car will attract more viewers to watch more, the Mitsubishi Lancer Evo X GSR. I say unusual because this is in a remarkable car, even though I lack knowledge about Lancers. Except I know the Lancer Evos rival the Subaru WRX STIs for decades in rally racing competition and asphalt. So bear with me, I'll do the best I can about the Lancer Evo X. So here's why the Evo X was the final generation of the Mitsubishi Lancer and still competitive with the Subaru STI till this day since its discontinuation. Well, it's been months since I reviewed a pure JDM car like the Honda NSX and Nissan 300ZX. Both videos received decent views, and there will be more JDM car reviews coming very soon. By the way, if you've never seen neither of those videos, go check them out after you finish watching this video if you're interested. Now, back on track. The Mitsubishi Lancer Evolution, as people refer to as Evo, is a high-performance version of the base Lancer designed for performance from its turbocharged inline 4 engine. The Evo X or Evo 10 marked the final generation of the Lancer Evo and also indicated the end of Impure JDM car era. Before it officially came out in the market for 2008, Mitsubishi introduced two concept versions of the final gen Evo. The first concept was shown in 2005 in Japan, named the Concept X, which was the same year when Mitsubishi introduced the Evo 9. Then in 2007, second concept car, the Prototype X, turned out nearly close to the production model, and then finally went on sale a year later. From the looks of the Evo X, the car got a whole new redesign subsequently to the Evo 9 and Evo 8, and the best looking and the fastest handling Evo yet. First, starting with the basics, the Evo X biggest improvement was underneath the bodywork, which is the engine. The engine is pretty much the same from the last Evos, but except this one featured a new design aluminum alloy 2-liter turbocharged inline 4 engine codenamed 4B11T that produces 290 brake horsepower and 300 pound-feet of torque. The engine is mated to GSR's conventional 5-speed manual gearbox or the MR model 6-speed dual clutch and feeds the newer all-wheel drive system, which combines with active center differential, yaw control, and stability control for better driving experience, and the most sophisticated Evolution drivetrain so far. Due to more horsepower and better transmission, the Evo 10 is capable from 0-60 mph in astonishing 4.8 seconds, or sometimes less than 5 seconds, and surpasses its predecessor in getting the power to the ground, launching hardest at high revs and hitting top speeds at 150 mph at 7,000 RPM redline. That sounds impressive. The chassis weight paid off in corners, where its extra stiffness helped yield big improvements, like the flare fenders to accommodate the increased track. BBS wheels with Brembo brakes improves the car's braking system while the wheels are light. The big grille and especially the hood air ducts improves engine cooling and the aerodynamics for the car to accelerate faster. The functional rear wing adds downforce at speeds over 90 mph and reduces the lift as the car travels fast, and direct airflow creates better stability in the process. The Evo X weighs 116 pounds more than a predecessor, but also the aluminum engine with variable valve timing saves 26 pounds and offers a stiffer but heavier platform while having a more refined interior. The Evo's design, in my opinion, is striking and cool. Although I never really was a huge fan of Lancer Evos like that, and they just never been my thing, honestly. But the Evo X looks fine, and the differences are there over the regular Lancer, like the wing, wheels, and is more powerful in all-wheel drive. One way you can tell this is the Lancer Evolution is from the front and rear. The Lancer Evo badge only appeared on the back of the car and does not appear anywhere else on the exterior, plus with the rear diffuser, the wing, and the hood vents. Now, a first look in the interior, everything in the interior does not appear so special, and the quality is pure basic from the cockpit. The features are clearly simple and understated with a lot of plastic stuff because majority was carried over from the base Lancer 10 into the Evo 10 for enthusiasts. But what do you get is the Vaccaro seats that are designed for comfort and hug the driver attacking the corners and drifting on a track, which is relevant to the character of this car. Despite the quad seating capacity, it was designed for the upfront passengers. The front features like the AWC button is the all-wheel drive control, and pressing it will adjust the drivetrain to optimize the car between three different terrains like tarmac, gravel, and snow, as displayed in the center screen between the gauges. Next is the basic climate controls, then the little infotainment non-touchable screen, while the steering wheel has so many buttons to interact. Over to the left of the steering wheel is the dial that adjusts the positioning of the headlights, while the button next over deactivates traction control or turns ABS off. The gauge clusters are very traditional, with the left tachometer and right speedometer with the digital screen to display the car's information. And that's pretty much where the fun aspect ends inside. The Evo was just never about luxury, but aimed towards performance, impressive fun factor, and evolved over the years during its production run. Next, we jump about the practicality. The trunk capacity of the Evo X is 14.3 cubic feet of cargo for luggages. That's enough room for pretty much big things. So you can certainly drive this every day regardless as a performance sedan. Now, prior to the Lancer Evo discontinued 5 years ago now, production of the Evo X lasted longer than any other Evolution car because I guess for one, this was the best Evo yet, while they created many variants for much more better power until the end, including the GSR, MR, and SE. There were more powerful ones such as the FQ400, which represented 400 horsepower, and FQ440MR is the most powerful Lancer Evo ever made. The production of the Evo X lasted for nearly a decade from 2008 until being discontinued in 2016, which sadly ended the iteration of the Mitsubishi Lancer. After since the Evo is just gone for good, and while the beloved name lasted for 25 years since the start in 1992 with the Evo 1, nobody, including tuner enthusiasts, forgotten about the Evo. Mitsubishi wasn't and still isn't the same without the Lancer and the Eclipse. While they're both iconic, as the manufacturer shifted away from the fun cars to focusing on EVs and boring crossovers, which crossovers are severely common today and even growing in the market. The Evo X left behind quite the legacy and remains an amazing performance sedan to this day. But let's talk about why did Mitsubishi dare to stop making Lancer Evos? Mitsubishi killed the iconic Rally Breed performance sedan because, long story short, like the same reason they stopped making all of its other performance cars, money shortage. More specifically, by consumer preferences, most buyers wanted cars that are practical, reliable, and economical. So basically, Mitsubishi currently focus making crossovers, SUVs, and electric hybrid car segments for people who buy commuter vehicles. Mitsubishi focus on the sector of the market where it's certain to get the best sales volume and profit, and that focus is on efficiency and reliability. They didn't want to invest in search and development and performance cars that are unlikely to make the sales number and profit required. So ever after the final Evo launched, the sales weren't really doing so well. Most people who really bought this car are tuner enthusiasts, and a lot of them are heavily modified. So Mitsubishi have no public plans to make any kind of new sports car, at least the Lancer Evo, as very unlikely. But here's good news. Despite being discontinued and outdated, the Evo X can still compete with the latest Subaru WRX STI that came out 13 years after it. The Evo X puts out almost the same horsepower as the recent WRX STI. The handling remains fantastic with a ton of grip, even by today's standards, and on par with the STIs. The rival best friends produce similar amounts of power, about nearly or over 300 brake horsepower. Both are capable of ample tuning, and they are both only one generation apart with a lot of similarities. When the Evo came out in 2008, Its Subaru competition at the time was the previous WRX STI, which was replaced by the current one in 2015, the same year when Evo X stopped with the final edition. Now, if Mitsubishi ever decided to resurrect the legendary Evo badge on the sports car in the near future, that's if other big Japanese car makers are successful with any new performance cars. Then maybe Mitsubishi might attempt to return back the Evo or at least brainstorm another new sports car. And if they do, don't expect it to be all internal combustion, maybe powered by an electric hybrid or even fully electric. But once again, it remains highly improbable and won't come again. As they say, sometimes all good things come to an end. And now, that is the official end of the car review of the Mitsubishi Lancer Evolution X. And I hope you guys really did sit back and relax and enjoy this video. And if you find this interesting, make sure to smash that like button. And I'll see you next time for some more upcoming videos. And you are more than happy to give me any car suggestions in the comments down below. Let's virtually walk to the Lancer Evolution X and put the keys into the ignition and start the engine. Make sure to adjust your headphone volume for the car sound. Peace out.